Today's question comes from Brian Harnish. Brian asks, what is a day in the life of a search spam team member like? What is the evolution of decisions in terms of how they decide which aspects of the search algorithm to update? Will certain things within the algorithm never be considered for removal? Ooh, okay, so those are some great questions. Let's talk through it a little bit. Remember, the web spam team has both engineers and manual spam fighters. So let's talk a little bit about both. If you're a manual spam fighter, what does your day look like? Okay, well, I have done a lot of manual spam fighting, but here's a rough idea of what might sort of happen. Typically, it's a mix of reactive spam fighting and proactive spam fighting. So reactive would mean we get a spam report or somehow we detect that someone is spamming Google. Well, we have to react to that. We have to figure out how do we make things better. And so a certain amount of every day is just making sure that the spammers don't infest the search results and make the search experience horrible for everyone. So that's sort of like, not hand-to-hand combat, but it is, saying yes or no, this is spam, or trying to find the spam that is currently ranking relatively well. And then in the process of doing that, the best spam fighters I know are fantastic at seeing the trends, seeing the patterns in that spam, and then moving into a proactive mode. And the proactive mode would involve trying to figure out how are they ranking so highly? What is the loophole that they're exploiting? How do we go to the root of the problem and try to fix it there? And that is a ton of fun. Sometimes that involves interacting with engineers, trying to say, okay, if you guys could tweak this or make this small algorithmic change, everything would get better. Sometimes it's just being able to identify a technique that a spammer uses, or even identifying a specific spammer and trying to say, okay, now we have some way of being able to catch what this particular black hat is doing, something along those lines. Okay, so let's talk about engineering. It's interesting because engineers, they absolutely look at the data, they absolutely look at examples of spam, but your average day is usually spent coding and doing testing of ideas. So you'll write up an algorithm that you think will be able to stop a particular type of spam. There's no one algorithm that will stop every single type of spam. Penguin, for example, is really good at one or several types of spam, but it doesn't tackle hacked sites, for example. So if you were an engineer, you might be working on, how do I detect hacked sites more accurately? So you come up with what you think are the best techniques you can use, all the different signals that you can marshal to support that. You write an algorithm that tries to catch as many hacked sites as possible while preserving safely the sites that are innocent. And then you actually test that out. You run that across our index, or you run an experiment with ratings from URLs and you say, do things look better? And a lot of the times doing that, or even live traffic experiments and seeing what people click on, will allow you to see what the false positives are, the sites that are getting caught that shouldn't be caught, or the sites that you aren't catching that you need to be able to catch. And so a lot of the day-to-day process of working in web spam is trying to figure out and hone those algorithms to improve your precision recall curve, basically, to try to catch more spam sites and make sure that you don't catch anybody who you believe is innocent. So that's fun and it's challenging because along the way you are also looking at what are the new trends, what are the new types of spam that are coming down the pipe, and that comes from the manual team, that comes from engineers, it comes from the outside world, it comes from feedback within Google, if there are other engineers who complain about problems that they see in the search results. And so to your next question, what is the evolution of decisions in terms of how they decide what aspects of the search engine algorithm to update? Well, we're always going back and revisiting and saying, okay, is this algorithm still effective? Is this algorithm still necessary given this new algorithm? And one thing that the quality team, the knowledge team, does very well is trying to go back and ask ourselves, okay, let's revisit our assumptions. Let's say if we were starting from scratch, would we do it this way? What is broken or stale or outdated or defunct compared to some other new way of coming up with this? And so we don't just try to have a lot of different tripwires that would catch a lot of different types of spam. You try to come up with elegant ways that will always catch spam and try to highlight new types of spam as they occur. Now, it's really hard because there's a massive amount of spam on the web and there's always people trying to make more spam. But it is really rewarding because you know that you're doing trying to do something good for the world, trying to do something important. And it is really an intellectual challenge because it's not like synonyms where you get one thing right and you're done and you get to go home for the day and the synonyms don't really change. or they change at a slower rate. Web spam is very dynamic, and so in a given week, we might see, you know, different changing sands that will change our priorities, where, you know, the landscape is moving a little bit on us. And so it's a lot of fun. We have a pretty good idea when we start at the beginning of the year what we'd like to work on, and yet when we look back at the end of the year and say, what did we actually tackle, sometimes it's very different. And a lot of that is because we're responding to the actual attacks that we see, we're responding to actual feedback, you know, the sorts of things that people are complaining about. But as far as an average day, it's true that there is no completely normal average day. Every day is a little bit unusual. Today we had a conspiracy theory that we were debunking. Someone was saying, hey, my name is whatever, whatever, and whenever you search for my name, you can't find me, and it's because I wrote something critical about Google. And the fact is, we're way too busy to worry about stuff like that. But we do try to debug that and diagnose what's going on, and, you know, is there some piece of data that's broken? How do we make things better? And whether the complaints come in from critics or, you know, people who are friendly to Google or from within Google, wherever that feedback comes from, you try to look at that kernel and you try to say, okay, there's probably some misunderstanding, something actionable we need to do to make it so that people don't get stressed out, so they don't worry about this the next time it comes up. So it's a lot of fun. Are there things that the algorithm will never be considered for removal? Well, other than saying, you know, the core pillars like, you know, separation between ads and organic search results, or if you buy ads, you won't rank higher, you won't rank lower. You know, we have some principles that we just do not want to ever call into question. But at the same time, everything else within search ranking is up for grabs, because if you can come up with a better, more elegant, cleaner, shorter, simpler way to do something, then you absolutely want to do it that way. So you always try to go back and revisit and say, can we make this architecture something that's stronger while still being simpler? It's a lot of fun. It's a good intellectual challenge. And there will probably be people trying to spam forever. So I think we'll have a job for quite some time to come. But we always try to say, okay, how do we look at a problem and then tackle it at the root? So you never want to play whack-a-mole with a particular type of spam or a particular spammer. You always want to be saying, how are they able to exploit the web, or confidence on the web, or people on the web, or software packages on the web, or our ranking, and try to find a way to plug that hole so that you help everybody downstream, not just taking care of that one specific incident. It's a lot of fun. We have a lot of fantastic people all around the world who work on spam. I'm very grateful that they tackle it, and they tackle it very well.